Hello and welcome to our class. The topic for today's discussion is testing. What is testing? Let's find out. In this chapter, we will define testing in the context of software systems. This is because softwares are present everywhere in our daily lives. A good example of this is business applications. Whether you want to book a flight out of an airport or make a purchase in a supermarket, or work on your office computer, softwares are everywhere. Another example would be consumer products. Everyday applications like the washing machine, smartphones, or your coffee maker are all run by software programs within them. So what do you expect from these products? You expect them to function perfectly whenever you need them. But to ensure that your applications run smoothly, developers have to create the right software, then subject it to a series of exams with scans for bugs and errors. This rigorous process is called testing. I hope that made sense. Before the software you developed is given to the user, you have to test it. It has to pass through a process that ensures that the product you have developed is ready to meet the user's expectations. And this process is called testing. So what happens if your software is released in the market and doesn't work properly? That software will be called a faulty software and will cause several negative consequences. Let's look at these consequences one at a time. The first one is a loss of money. Let's take a real-life example. This was an article in the newspaper about a company recalling its car due to its faulty airbags. Once this kind of news hits the market, the share value of such a company will plummet, causing even more loss of money. The second consequence is time. Since this product is already in the market, you have to bring it back from shops and warehouses. Then you have to work on the product again. And in the meanwhile, you have to do damage control from the public relations perspective. All of that consumes a lot of time. The third consequence is your business reputation. To use another real-life example, there was a hacker who had access to eBay's user database for 229 days. This was a breach of the security software, which means that this software was faulty. It was not effective in the way the company had expected it to be, and this led to a loss of business reputation for eBay. The final consequence to keep in mind is injury or death. The failure of certain softwares can have grave results. To take the example of the faulty airbags in the recalled cars, you can see from this video that the airbag system is leaking air from this section here, which means that its function is compromised. It is faulty. This type of fault can result in injury or death. These are all the reasons why we need thorough software testing. Hope it's all clear, and I'll see you in the next video. Until then, happy testing.